Welcome, kids, to Disciple Town, brought to you from Bolingbrook Church. I'm so excited to see you every single week. And if you are having a great time, go get your special adult so they can like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube and Facebook channels. Now, what are we doing today? We have been studying about an element. An element is a building block of our faith, and this whole month we've been learning about the great cobbler. Oh, I'm really hungry, but no, that doesn't sound right. The great consumption. Oh no, that's like a really bad disease. The really great committee. I'm getting closer. I can kind of feel it. It's the Great Commission. Remember, this was the last command that Jesus gave to his disciples before he went to heaven. And it's the same command that is for us as well. We have been learning about three different things. And this is the first one, was making disciples. Well, that is just like Disciple Town. That's literally learning how to be a Christian, how to live like Christ. Our second one was baptism. Baptism is the way that you tell the whole world that you're on Team Jesus. And I love that idea, to be on a team with Jesus. And then last week, we learned about obeying Jesus' words. So we've got a lot more to do, but before that, we need to have prayer. So get your hands, your eyes. You can kneel or you can stand, whatever you would like, and get ready to talk to Jesus. Dear Jesus in heaven, thank you so much for the opportunity to pray to you, that you love us talking to you in conversation. And we can come to you when we're happy. We can come to you when we're sad. We can come to you when we're angry, and you will listen. We want to hear your words, dear Jesus, and have your words teach us what we should do and how we should live for you. So please help us to open our minds and learn from you today. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, now, jump up, get the wiggles out. It's time to do some worship and some singing. And are we ready? Hit it, Pastor Dave.
Jesus, I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided. silent flocks by night. Behold throughout the heavens, there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is
Oh, Go Tell It on the Mountain, one of my most favorite Christmas songs of all time. But here's the thing, is that only for Christmas singing? Or could we sing that song all year long? Because part of that is our Great Commission. So that reminds me of our memory verse. So remember our memory verse. It is, therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. Matthew 28, 19 and 20. Now, there's some really important words in this Bible verse that I want to see if you remember. So I'm going to say the memory verse, and then I'm going to stop, and you think of the word that comes next. Therefore, go and make... Does everybody know that one? Disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age. Well, you guys did an excellent job. And if you notice, these were key words that we have learned the last 3 weeks. Disciples, baptizing, and obey. So what are we gonna learn today? I have a hint on what we're learning about today, but I have a game called Hat Hints. And I need help from Miss Debbie. Miss Debbie, where's Miss Debbie? I need your help, Miss Debbie. We gotta play this hat game. The kids are waiting. Oh, so glad you came to join us. So we have a game, and we're gonna show you some hats, And you take a look at it and we'll talk about it later. So did you get it? These were hats from all kinds of people from everywhere in the whole world. You know, the Bible has something to say about that. And Miss Demi, take it away. Okay, Disciple Town kids, we have had so much fun so far, but now it's time for our lesson. So we've already looked at what it is to talk about the Great Commission. Now, in the Great Commission, do you remember what it says? It says to go. What does it mean to go? Well, today we're talking about missionaries. What is a missionary? A missionary is someone who is sent on a religious mission, especially to promote Christianity in a foreign country. So, again, let's look at our Great Commission. What does it tell us to do? It tells us to go make disciples, right? Well, do you know who was the first missionary? I'll give you a hint. There was 12 of them. That's right. Who were they? It was Jesus' disciples, right? And so when he left them, his last commandment was to his disciples to go make disciples out of others. So now they became missionaries. They're also disciples, were also known as the apostles. And you can find all about what the apostles did in a book called Acts. It talks about all of the apostles. Now, there was one apostle that was really out front who was kind of leading all this, and that was Peter. He was kind of the first missionary and went a lot of places. And not only him, once he was around, there was also this other guy named Paul, also known as Saul of Tarsus. Now he has a conversion story like none other. You can find his story in Acts chapter 9. In fact, let's take a look at this video and talk about Paul.
The Miracle of Mercy, Paul. This is Saul. Saul was a Pharisee who hated the followers of Jesus so much that he would hunt them down to be brought to trial in Jerusalem. And he would even seek to murder them. Saul was uttering threats with every breath, and he was eager to kill the Lord's followers. So he went to the high priest. He asked him to write a letter to the Jews in Damascus that would allow him to arrest any Christians he found there. He wanted to bring them, both men and women, back to Jerusalem in chains. Now Saul went on his way. And as he came near Damascus, a light from heaven flashed around him, and he heard a voice that said, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" Saul cried out, "Who are you, Lord?" And the voice said, "I am Jesus. Rise and go into the city, and you will be told what to do." So Saul got up and he opened his eyes, but he couldn't see anything. So the men who were with Saul led him into the city. After 3 days, a man named Ananias came to Saul. He put his hands on Saul and immediately Saul could see again. And with that, Saul became a follower of Jesus. He became the very thing he had tried to hunt. And he immediately began telling people that Jesus is the Son of God, and he taught them about the mercy of God that he had received. And all who heard him were amazed. He then went by a new name, Paul, as he began preaching not just to the Jewish people, but to everyone. Despite many difficulties like being imprisoned, shipwrecked, and narrowly escaping death multiple times, Paul continued to preach about Jesus. Paul said that he would do everything he could to save people and help them know God. And that's just what he did in order to reach people who would otherwise be unreached. And many came to know Jesus because of what Paul said. Paul taught many in his day through his letters, but even more have come to learn more about Jesus through the letters of Paul that can be read even to this day.
Wow, wasn't that a fantastic story that Paul had? There are so many missionaries out there. Let's say there's a couple. I got a few names for you, like William Anderson. He, in 1895, he was a missionary to Africa. David Livingston, you might have heard of him, like Dr. Livingston, I presume. 1840, he was also in Africa, but he went all around the whole continent of Africa, mapping out where villages were at. And so he didn't spend a lot of time in one place, but he was there and he was teaching and bringing the message of Jesus to each of those villages. Then there was a John Tay who went to the South Pacific. And then, the most famous missionary that I know is Mother Teresa. She was born in 1910, and when she was 19, she became a nun. And when she was 21, she went to Calcutta, India, and became a teacher. While she was there, she saw so many people that needed to hear the message of Jesus. There was somebody that was sick, and some that had leprosy, so many that were hungry and that lived in the streets. It was terrible, and her heart just broke for them. And she had a mission statement. Her statement was, looking after the people that no one else would. So that was important to her, right? She spent her entire life taking care of these people in Calcutta until the age of 87, when she was no longer with us. There are so many places in our world that needs God's word, like places like China, Korea, Africa, Peru, Alaska. In fact, my son went to Alaska and he spent a whole week there in a remote village building a church and bringing vacation Bible school to the children in the village. I have a friend who works with a committee that is called Hearts for Hades. And in that program, they bring fresh water to remote villages in Haiti. And that project is called impactforjesus.org. You can look that up. Now, there are so many levels of missionary work that you can do. Doctors and nurses and pilots and builders. Maybe you're just not ready right now to do any part of that mission work, but there's something you can do. What you could do is you could support, donate some money to the mission field to help the workers take care of God's people. We can be Jesus' hands and feet anywhere we go. And wherever you go, Jesus will go too.
Thank you, Miss Debbie. That was an awesome story. In fact, it's gotten me all powered up and energized and, how many of you have a passport and your own jet? Because I want to go to other countries too, but do you have a passport and your own jet?
Oh no!
I hope that doesn't mean that I can't do the Great Commission. But wait a minute. The Great Commission can happen anywhere. So remember, it started when Jesus went back to heaven and he gave the Great Commission to his disciples, and just 12 people started going out and making new disciples. And now 2,000 years later, there's over 2 billion Christians in the world. And so that comes from each one telling another and another and another. And What happens if you can't fly to another nation? Did you know you could be a missionary right where you live? Where's my hat? Where's my hat? I need a hat for this part. Oh, here goes. Did you know that I live in Chicagoland? Do you know that I could be a missionary in my own neighborhood, in my own grocery store, in my own school, in my own house? So you can tell people about Jesus coming to earth and dying for their sins. But here's another question. What am I gonna do if they don't listen? There is always going to be people that don't listen. And there's another way that you can show Jesus' love to them. And that's the way you act, the way you talk, and the way you treat people. That is showing people's Jesus' love through the way you are. And it's easy to be nice and loving to your best friend, like Miss Debbie. But what about the grouchy neighbor? What about the angry kid next door that calls you names? There's all kinds of opportunities to be kind in a world that's full of grouchy people. Show everybody God's love by the way you are. Now, this means that you can be a difference maker too. And the way you act, there could be people coming to heaven because of you. That's what the Great Commission is. It's all about having as many people in heaven as possible because Jesus loves people. So, where's my Miss Debbie? Where's my Miss Debbie? We got one more thing we got to talk about.
Hi.
Does everybody notice what shirts we're wearing today? This is our Be the Light shirts. Do you know that when you show other people Jesus, you are being the light? And we have lights behind us and lights all over. I want you guys to go out there and be a light to everybody around you to show Jesus love. So I think we need a prayer. Let's fold hands, close eyes. Dear Jesus in heaven, thank you so much for the words that you've given us and your explanations in your Bible that tell us what to do. Please give us the strength to do it and the understanding to do it and help us live for you every single day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
So it's been so great hanging out with you today. We're gonna see you later. So bye, friends.